Gauhar Jaan. The Datia Incident is the story of India's first recording artist, Gauhar Jaan, and one of the earliest music producers, the American musician Fred Gaisberg. He travels across India in 1902 to capture her beautiful voice, but encounters many unexpected adventures along the way, including the famous Datia Incident as well. I'm joined by the talent behind this production, Mukul Ahmed, Ashesha Kapoor and Ateli Pakek. Hello to you.
Hi.
Wow, what a story this is. Can you just briefly explain what it's all about? Because it's a famous one, isn't it? But I must confess, I wasn't familiar with it at first. But tell me about it.
The time was, so fertile for that kind of cultural kind of explosion globally. And Freddie Gaisberg, he traveled to India with this new invention, the Pandora's box called gramophone.
Yeah, that we now know famously.
She took the risk because male singers, they didn't want to record their voice out of two reasons. One is the superstition that their voice would be stolen.
Okay.
And others, they thought that their trade would be, the secret would be open, others would learn. But she took the challenge and the revolution, I would say. And the whole classical Indian music was controlled by men. And it was the court musicians they controlled. But she took the decision.
Wow.
And, you know, that took some courage and the vision and unshackled that. And women, they got pride and recognition and I believe affluency because of these records they sold in hundreds of thousands in India.
And now look at today. I mean, you've got thousands of female singers from India. So she was a real pioneer of her time.
Yeah, she was incredible. I mean, she was definitely the first diva of her time. She was very extravagant, flamboyant, and
look
she had
at her. She's fabulous.
Yeah. She had a presence when she walked into a room. I mean, sure. I read her biography, and it's just when she walked in, you know, she could silence her room with her presence.
That's a diva. That's what you need to be, exactly. A diva, don't you? Yeah. And what does this tell us about society and culture at the time in India?
Well, it was very much confined in the Mughal courts because the ordinary people, they didn't have any access. Like we hear today, okay, just a earphone and we listen. It wasn't like that.
It was
confined
classes.
To only these some and upper classes. So I'd say that we have to embrace that technology. It can be a blessing because how it democratized music and globally the building bridges, actually. So technology, you know, just brought India in a kind of recognition globally and worldwide. And to add on top of that, she recorded 600 songs during her career in 20 different languages, including French and English. And we are going to play some recordings that Anjali...
we have an exhibition supporting it.
Okay.
So you can delve a little bit deeper into her life.
Sure. And where can we see this? Where
so this
is
the Omnibus Theatre in Clapham. And it starts on the play starts on the 10th of April. But we put the show up today, so that's opening tomorrow. So definitely come by and check it out. And you can hear music from 1902. Her original recordings with Freddie himself. And she sings in over 20 languages, which is pretty incredible, really.
That's very incredible. Did she actually speak 20 languages then?
I doubt it. I think she did. She was very prolific in quite a few languages.
Yeah.
Her background was English, American and Indian, so she was quite an exotic creature of the time as well.
Excellent. Okay, so we can see this in Clapham as of now, right?
It's Omnibus Theatre.
Omnibus Theatre.
The play starts on the 10th and the exhibition starts tomorrow to support it.
Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. I appreciate your time today.
Thank you.